Back to Valkyrie's Art Corner. I know, stupid beginning. Today I'm going to be working on a dragon drawing. So, I'm just setting up for a minute, getting everything in line how it's supposed to be. Making sure I'm getting some pings out there so I'm not just sitting in here all by my lonesome. Actually have some people to talk to while I'm in here. So today I am doing a drawing stream because we have a really bad thunderstorm going on right now. So there's a good possibility that I could lose some power. So I don't want to be playing Resident Evil 8 and then all of a sudden, boop, power goes out, then I'm screwed. So yeah, that's what I'd be doing. Go right down here, post here. Bum 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 bum. Well, I'm about to sneeze. Alright, so now I can get back to my drawing now that I have all that out of the way. To go down and up and make it come out like that. Wow, I'm gonna change this right here because that don't look right. Hello, Aragon, welcome in. I welcome you in to my humble show. Get some grooves going on in here. Hello, what the dab? Welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm happy you guys are all here. Trying to get my Twitch pulled up here. So how are you guys doing today? Yeah, I'm kind of at the start of it, so it's like, yeah. And I'm drawing a dragon because I felt like drawing a dragon today. I was going to stream Resident Evil 8, but I have, like I said earlier, a really bad thunderstorm going on right now, so I don't want to get too far into the game and then all of a sudden all my progress get lost. That's great to hear. I'm just in a really good mood right now, so I'm like kind of jamming out. I'm just doing my base drawing right now. And then I'm gonna add shading and stuff to it here in a bit. I was actually really wanting to play Resident Evil 8, but like I said, I need to fix that line. Start drawing some feathers here. I appreciate that. So this dragon, he's gonna have like a mix of scales and feathers, which is kind of what's right here. So I'd say he's kind of more like oh, whatchamacallit, a bird dragon. Where he has, yeah, you get the idea. And thank you to the three viewers currently in here. I highly appreciate it. Come down here with that. So what's everyone's plans toward the weekend? Because I know it's only Thursday, but it's never too early to start planning your week end. Now, the bigger question is, what am I colors am I going to do this once I get them finished? Probably be streaming. What do you plan on streaming? Probably Minecraft. See, I have yet to play Minecraft. I have seen players p play it, but I don't, I have never personally played Minecraft myself. He might stream right now. Well, that's fine. Seemed like my stream crashed for a minute. It might just be on my end, though. What's going on, Anagamiax? Yeah, like I said, I'm doing kind of like a dragon bird. I felt like doing a dragon, but then I was like, yeah, maybe do I want to do a dragon? Did my stream freeze? Freeze? Oh, I think I'm frozen. Thank you to the 5 viewers in here. There we go. Okay, my stream's not frozen anymore. Good, I was freaking out a minute. I was like, why are we freezing? There we go. Now it's all set back. Yeah, I don't like how that turned out right there. I have no clue what colors I'm going to do him in. So, that's something I'm going to have to figure out. Really digging this the songs that are on Pretzel Rocks right now. Now I'll leave it up to you guys. Should I go colorful on him, or should I just leave him more like more monochromatic, or So I can do a lot of shading with him and everything like that. Hold on, I just had somebody message me. Did my music stop? Oh. It was just being a pain in the butt. Let's see, why does it seem like my stream is so delayed? Go away! I don't want this. My computer decided it wanted to do a pop-up. Okay. You want to play like that, bro? You want to play? Let's play. Fatality. I'll just continue to draw because it seems like I'm having a really bad delay. So I'll answer questions and stuff as they come up. What are you doing? I do not want Microsoft Edge. Go away. Jeez. I guess that's what happens when I stream on an old computer. It's like, oh, okay, you're streaming. Let's act up. Hey, yo. Welcome, welcome, welcome. How you doing? I think there's a significant delay in the stream, so if it seems like I'm ignoring you, I'm really not. I'm just catching up with the chat as it pops up. I don't know if I'm liking this dragon too much. I might erase this and start over on something else. Not sure. I just gotta see how it turns out. Probably it's because it's line work and I don't like necessarily like line work. Why'd I have to pick something I'm not gonna to like? He's gonna have lots of scales and everything like that, so. Boom, boom. thing is being a pain in my butt. Oh, is that project that you were talking to me about? Because if that's the case, I have already started, and I will show you a little later on down the line what it looks like. I don't know if I'm liking this too much. I might choose another one. Oh, a different one. Gotcha. Yeah, I'm thinking about choosing something else. Yeah, if I don't like something, I will typically just stop on it. I think I found one that's better. I'm going to erase this one. I don't like it. Bye-bye, Mr. Dragon. Let's try a different dragon. I want to draw Toothless the Dragon from How to Train Dragon sleeping with a cat curled up beside it for a friend. You know what? I could do Toothless. He'd be pretty fun to draw. Let me see. Now be warned, I am doing this live, so it may not be as good as when I actually take my time to draw it. See. So that way it'll kind of help you it'll kind of help you out a little bit on how to draw it. Let's see. I haven't found one that I particularly like. I think I might just do a side shot and maybe on his eye. Yeah, I feel like I'm doing an eye today. No, not calligraphy. That's why I was having issues, butthead. We will come this way with his mouth. And then his lower jaw. funny thing about Toothless is he's like a cat. Hello, I'm doing pretty good. How are you? I'm doing pretty good. Right now I'm currently attempting to draw Toothless. I'm gonna try doing him in kind of like a, just a stylized thing. Man, I don't like this either. What the hell? Probably just do a whole Toothless. I didn't come on here with a plan. I should have come on here with a plan. Oh, you know what I could do? Do let me know if there's a huge delay, because like I said, sometimes like I'll answer your question and then I won't hear nothing, or you guys won't talk, and it's like, yeah. Okay, so. And then come up here like this. And then come over like this. And you'll see what I'm doing with it here in a minute. It may not look much right. Oh, that's too big. I was about to erase the whole thing. Nope. Dang, why does it seem like my stream has a huge freaking delay? I don't like that, and it's making me angry. Okay, let's go this way with the wing. And the other part comes down and out. Yeah, I do apologize for any delay that it's causing. If you guys do talk, I will answer as soon as I see it pop up. Ooh, that would be bad. I'm just not sure why it's doing what it's doing, and it's making me very upset. Nope, that's what I thought. Where am I? Of course, I'm missing connectors here, here. There. Try now. Let's go to the next layer. Okay, we will color in this Sir all black. Except for the eyes. Probably only gonna need like a couple layers on this. Cause it's gonna be a very simplified drawing of Toothless. Just so that people get the general idea. Now the reason why I'm not filling this all the way in is because I am on another layer. So if I do that, it'll turn the whole thing black. And we don't want that. And my internet's being wonky. It's probably because of the storm outside. Yeah, I know. I noticed I got holes in the left foot. I just now noticed I had holes in the left foot. Good catch, though. But I needed to do it on a separate layer anyway. So that way... So that way I could actually blend out what I needed. I hate this delay because, like, as I'm looking at the stream, I've already got his left foot almost completely covered in, his head almost colored in, his ears almost colored in. It's just so weird on the delay. And see, what I'm gonna have to do on him is I'm probably gonna do a neon glow. Dang it. I should have lifted my pen when I did that. There we go. Kind of makes me sad because, like, I want to be able to talk to you guys in real time, but... The stream decides it wants to do its own thing. Yeah, dragons, depending on what I'm doing, I have to be in the mood to do it. And thank you to the 4 viewers that are sticking around with me. I greatly appreciate it. I appreciate your time hanging out with me and everything like that. And Now, all my stuff is not necessarily going to be all art content. I'm eventually going to go back to playing video games, but I have had some really bad weather the last few days, so I've had a few projects that I've been trying to work on in the before the rain comes, but every time I get to them, I get rained out, and it's the kind of stuff that I will need to be outdoors for, because my dad wants to get them done. And one of the projects is that it's a full set of Mandalorian armor, because my dad wants to wear it for a cosplay convention. Oh jeez, Rick. Gosh, why did I sneeze? I hate these stupid allergies. Like, the pollen level and stuff was high today too. And the cicadas are out in full force today too, so they're being noisy. Guys, did you forget it's raining out there? You're not supposed to be making noises. I'm just doing a quick simplified drawing of Toothless. Just trying to make him look badass a little bit. So that way, maybe on one of these ones I'll draw more detailed Toothless. Just to see how that goes. Now, is my stream buffering or anything like that? Because my stuff, I think, is being a pain in the butt. It's the stupid weather outside. There we go. Now it's popping back up. Doggy dog, please stop chewing on yourself. Hey! No. Stop chewing on yourself. I know you're itchy. But you need to stop chewing on yourself, dog. And I gave you a bath yesterday, butthead. Or are you just doing it because you're bored, buddy? I could take that as a reason. Almost done coloring him in. Yay! Make this thing a little smaller so you can color him in. There we go. Now I can make that paintbrush a little bit bigger. I think that's looking pretty cool, don't you think? All right, let's go make a new layer up here. So now I'm going to do a bright green. Probably need to go soft on that. No, not that big. then come around this way with it. And once I get these green highlights in, I'm gonna go back through it with white to give it more of like a neon glow pop. I think that's looking pretty cool. Your puppy, lie down. Be good boy, lie down. There she go, good boy. Thank you to the four viewers that are currently in here with me in the stream. I greatly appreciate you. Oh no! Might have to do the eyes on a different layer. Yeah, probably have to do the eyes on a different layer. Oop, let me adjust myself real quick. Need to straighten my legs out. When I sit cross-legged too long, my knees are like, no, you're not the young lady that you once remembered you to be. Now I'm gonna make you cramp up. Alright, so I'm gonna lower this down and run white through it. That way, give it kind of that cool neon. That cool neon thing. The thing that it does. I'm happy that I'm streaming today because my sister has been kind of driving me batty. Gotta follow that line. You can't just make a straight line where there's no straight line. If you haven't noticed yet, I talk to my drawings, so don't mind me. I know this is not as amazing as the Faye Valentine one that I did, but I kind of just decided this on a whim. Okay, I need to do another layer. I need to go back to this green. This in, get this all nice and cool looking. Smaller again. There we go. Oh, you're lurking? Thanks for the lurk. Any kind of lurking is fine. So I'm going to do a next layer, fill it in with a darker green, nah, probably darker. Let's see, I don't think I have it on. I am not feeling drawing today. See if I can find a pattern for this. And do like the bright neon. Maybe. Nope, not that one. They have one called a blurred rainbow. Let's see what that does. I love it. Let's try something else. Why does that look like complete and utter crap? There we go. That one's a little... That one's a little bit more up my alley. Why did that skip? I'm just screwing around right now. I'm not really like going for perfectionism. I'm just kind of. What is this? I have not played with this one yet. What is that one? I don't know if I like that. Okay, that makes that look cool. Okay. to soap bubble. Am I going to do soap bubbles? I am just playing around with all the effects right now. I'm not really... doing anything of importance. I don't know if I'm going to save that. Looks like crap. I'm going to get out of that. Don't save. I didn't like that. I'm very indecisive today. Sometimes I get in one of those moods where I don't like anything I draw at all. So what I may do real quick is kind of give you a... If you're still in here, Aragon, I will do a quick rundown on how to draw a head or a human, I think. I think my stream is just glitching out. Okay, so but yeah, I'm just in one of those moods right now where I don't like anything I'm drawing. So yeah, network error, please. I think my whole thing is just being a pain in the butt. Okay, so if you can see this, the way I start drawing stuff is I always start with the eye. And this is like my more simplified version. It's not going to necessarily be super, super good or anything like that. But this is how I start out on the process of doing human. I do a human eye like this. That part is too long. So I just kind of curve it over. And then just follow it around here. Sometimes, depending on what stylization I want to go with, draw a curve under here. Follow the eye along the bottom. And then I always start with the eyes. And depending on where I want to... Oh, my. I drew kind of... And then come down this way. I always draw like half circles for the eyes. Now, right now, I'm not using any references or anything like that. So it's just... I'm just... kind of creating it from my brain. Because it's like flashing me on. And then. I'm trying to do this quickly instead of just like taking my time on it. Otherwise, I make it look really magnificent when I take my time. This is just like a quick tutorial though. You can use like any shape depending on the style of hair you want to do. Or anything like that. You can just draw miscellaneous shapes like so. I don't like this nose and I don't like this mouth. Gosh, why do I hate everything today? I am so mad. Why do I hate everything today? I'll go back to the mouth. Most of the times I just do the eyes first and then the face, depending on if I like the nose or not. You better watch out now, Tim Burton said he loved it and he lying like Simba. What's this guy talking about? It's something like Tim Burton and the Lion, like Simba. Simba didn't lie. There we go. I like that a little bit better. And then draw the shoulders down like that. Yeah, this is completely no references. Just kind of drawing it out of my head. This is how I normally start like quick doodles if I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to do. And then I go back and like decide whether or not if I want to change some things on it, like right here. I think it's he or she's chin is a little too pointy. I want to go more rounded. Go like this. I'm doing like a little bit more of like a traditional anime instead of like my realistic anime look. And then like with the forehead ratio, here I'll go on a different layer just to show you. The way you want to look at it, so I'm drawing on a different layer, so that way if you want to draw your line, that's where the eyes would go. And that's typically where the mouth goes. And then where the corner of the eyes are right here is where the nose goes typically. And then the eyes right here match up with the corners of the mouth. And then the top of the ears typically run with the top of the eyes, depending on anime or anything, if they're going to be larger or smaller. And then the head is an oval shape. I can't do an oval shape right now, but you want to make it plenty of room for the hairline, because if you do the hairline too short, like say you put the bangs right here, then the forehead's going to look really, really shallow, unless that's the style you want to go with. Oh no, did I just, oh hell no, I just drew that all over my drawing. I was supposed to get another layer for that. But yeah, that's the, I'll draw them back on there real quick. I'll go to another layer, make sure. Okay, so yeah, the line where the head's gonna go, eyes, mouth, nose, ears go to right just under here, and then an oval for the head. I'll do my art lesson today, so that way I can do, well, this one's kind of an androgynous one where it could be a male or a female. So it all depends on which way you want to go with it. So yeah, oval for the heads, line for the center line. And then for the neck, you'll want to draw that. And then like you go over here and then you kind of draw where the line goes. And then the outlines that go out the side of the neck to kind of show the exaggeration of the, where it's, I think it's called the trapezius. Yeah, and that's that one right there. I'll go back up to the top one. And then what you want to do is where the shoulders are, you kind of want to put a circle there where you kind of want it. And then a circle goes right here where you would choose to put the shoulders. So depending on which way I want to go with this, I could easily turn this into a female or anything like that. So you see where that comes into play? I'll finish drawing his or hers hair real quick. If I wanted to go that route, because right now this person's kind of a little bit androgynous. Like I said, it could flip either way. And then see where the lines are, where I drew them. You want to draw the shoulders and just follow your own guidelines. So now we're going to go back up here. See where I drew the neckline, stuff like that, and the circle for the shoulders. You want to draw where your body's center line wants to go, and that's where this is. So with that, and then the circles are like where you can, that's where everything's situated. And then from that big circle, you want to draw your triangle or your rib cage right here. And right here, that's where your rib cage would be. That's typically where the muscle lines will cross over like this. And then right here, where your torso would be, that kind of thing, but I made it kind of small just to kind of cram it in there, kind of thing. Let's see if I eliminate that. See the shoulders, it kind of comes into play. Let's see, I kind of want to draw him wearing, or her, draw something like this real quick. And see, also a good tip, what my grandpa used to teach me, is that when you do your shoulder lines and stuff like that, you want your head to be able to, like, when you naturally come down, touch the edge of your shoulder. So if you look at it without the line, actually I'll draw it on here since I can eliminate it. No, did I not? Damn it. You'll want the, at least this part of the head to come down to where the edge of the shoulder is. So when you lay your own head down, you can actually see that's the same exact distance of where it needs to go. I'm gonna put that back up there and draw it like right here so you guys can. So that way that's on there. And then hide that. And then where I have like all the torso and stuff drawn, like I could draw down here. Oh no, that's the wrong one. See where the shoulders are, depending on which way you want them to go, you just make a long oval shape and a circle where the elbow would go. Again, draw another long shape like that where the elbow goes. But typically if you're looking at like, here, I'll go ahead and draw the torso thing up here so you can actually see where the shoulders are. Rule of thumb is your elbow joint should end about where your hips are. A lot of people make this mistake and make them too short because the forearm needs to come down like that. And like that. And then where your hips are, right here, get your joints for your legs. Typically, if the arms are not bent, you want them to come down to at least midway to your thigh or just above your kneecap. Have that come down like that. And then just keep adding on circles. Circles go where the joints go. And then a block for the foot. Block for the foot. And for the hands, it's really simple. And then you just draw a finger. Draw a finger, kind of come down like that, and then like draw where the thumb is, and then you can add your fingers, add your knuckle joints and stuff like that, and eventually just kind of like trace over it. Tracing is fine if you're practicing. And see, this is where the actual joint for the arm would go, the forearm. And you start small and going out. That kind of thing. So this, like I said, it's not a good drawing, but I'm just showing the basics of how to do the drawing. And see, this part would right here would come down here. And see, this is where you would start refining and redrawing your lines and stuff like that to make it look good. And like a lot of people have problems with hands. So like right here, if you want to do it again, can always do like this, like a fixed knuckle kind of thing and the thumb. And then technically your fingers would come down here just like this and this part like that. So you actually see the insides of the hand. And a lot of people find hands really hard to draw. So also you would draw your little box this way. If you're wanting to draw your fingers out this way. I know it looks like a chunky little ham. Kind of stuff like that with the hands. But the best way to like do hands is to practice. Or like, it's the same way like with this stuff right here. It's the palm joint where the thumb is. And then right here, 2, 3, 4, if you actually want to show, because technically these are the tendon lines that run down here through the middle of the palm. And then if you want to, you could do joint. So you can just draw your little sausages like this. And then draw the tips of the fingers. No, the pinky's typically not that big though. I'm not being a good example. And typically the fingers have 1, 2, 3 three joint kind of thingies. So that's the main goal, is you just want to have 1, 2, and 3. And typically on most hands, the middle finger is taller than the rest of the fingers. So now you have a hand kind of thing. And the thumb only has 1 and 2. So that's a cool thing. So when you draw your shapes and stuff like that, when you think of it, here, I can hide this drawing right here so we can just show the base drawing. And it's like that with the feet and the ankles too. So like say the ankle's a ball joint, anything that's a ball joint can be considered a circle. For the foot, think of it as a box. And then you have your ball joint here. For your toes, and typically the arch goes like this, and this technically would be like your tendon back here. So technically here's the ball of the foot and here's the heel of the foot. So most of the time if you're just dealing with that, you just take that and erase it, and then boom, you get your foot, that kind of thing. And then the front of the foot is kind of like the hand, where this would technically be whatchamacallit, the flat of the foot. So you'd have 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5. And then this is where like the tendons, if you would think of it, they go up that way. And the ball joint where the ankle is. And then I know it looks funny, but actually, believe it or not, the ankle kind of sets offset. Like here's one ankle joint, and then the inner one is always high. This is going to make people a little bit self-conscious of where everything's at. The inner ankle joint is typically higher than the outside one. And it's like, not necessarily with just humans and stuff like that, because a lot of people, I know that I'm probably trying to, I'm bashing on them a little bit, but like with furries, for example, animals are the same way. I can hide these and actually, I will actually add another layer. So for references for animals and stuff like that, the eyeball is always a circle. And then, let's see, what kind of an animal are we going to do? Let's say, let's try a horse. Because a lot of people have issues with horses. And that was one of the first ones that I started on. Okay, so with horses, typically you have your eye socket. You got your circle here for the jaw. You kind of have the start of your rectangle right here that comes up like this. You got the back of the head. It's typically like that. And then you have the nose. So you can kind of see where the horse shape is coming from. And then you would just add nostrils in like that. And the way I draw horses' faces, I tend to make them a little bit pointed because their noses tend to come down in like a little bit of a point like that. And then their lower lip has that. And then they have this like gentle slant that comes down just like that. See where the shapes are coming into play though? And then when you want to like place where the ears are, just draw a triangle and then draw another triangle. Again, this is the back of the head. So you have your circle here. And then the neck is just like this. So that way, and also you have your neckline that comes down like that. So the horses always have that neckline, if you notice, and then you kind of draw out where the neck goes, and see this is where the other part of the circles come into play. So there's your shoulder blade, and that's when you start kind of going off in like your little oval shapes right here. It's almost like the humans at that point. Where you can draw your shapes, it and then like horses' elbows are typically right here, and this is actually the top of their shoulder blade right here, and the front of their shoulder is actually right there. So when you see horses from the side, you'll see like this lump right here, and then that under part that's kind of like technically the breast, and then there's like your elbow joint where it comes down. But they have like all this like muscle definition stuff like that. So see, this is where you can kind of get your ideas for the ears. And horses have these pretty. Pretty low-shaped eyes. Then they have like that part that kind of runs down there. And depending on like, see, this also gives you guidelines to show you where the bridles would go. Like right here. And then that comes down like that. So if you wanted to draw a harness on them or whatnot, it's just really simple. And then you can draw your hair. I'm just having fun with it now. So yeah. Since I didn't really know what to draw today, and tomorrow hopefully is a nice sunny day, I figured I'd just give you guys an art tutorial and stuff like that. So, with that being said, it's short stream. Not really too much activity today, so I'm gonna go ahead and end my stream. Do appreciate everyone that came in here today. Hopefully, I educated you a little bit. So, yeah, I'm gonna try probably closer to about 7 o'clock tomorrow instead of 6:30, because 6:30 kind of clashes with what I'm doing earlier in the day. So, yeah, thank you all for coming. Love every single one of you.